Generic greetings. FTL now has achievements, which means there's no better time and no better excuse to sink another 80 hours into this thing. By the way, today's beverage is a very thick, creamy, and delicious banana milkshake, something I normally don't indulge on, but it is very nice. Okay, so when this game came out in 2012, good grief, I'm getting old, I played it a lot and sunk a lot of time into it. I lost pretty much entire weekends and recommended and covered it highly. We played it on the channel loads, and I probably got about 50 to 60 hours in not... I wouldn't say it's more than a couple of months, really. I think it was, yeah, probably a couple of months where I got that amount of playtime on it. And, you know, you see what the game has to offer and you sort of leave it there. And then you start modding it and it doesn't count your time played. So that's probably another 30, 40 hours on there. And then you leave it by the wayside again. You're playing other things. And, oh, look, the Advanced Edition comes out. Loads more content. So you jump back in and play it some more. And now there's achievements out for it, which only really highlights what I haven't seen in the game. If we've got a new game here and we've got a list, we can say there's one, two ships that I haven't got. I know that that's still cruising. And that is unidentified, but I know what it is. It's a crystalline type thing. One of my friends has it unlocked, and there's loads of different types of things that I haven't got unlocked. And the reason why I really like the way they've done the achievements here is because most of them, if not all, are tied to just getting these done, which not only gives you a little, you know, you get a little achievement, you get a card, whatever, which is something I don't really care for. I'm not really bothered about getting that arbitrary ticky box, but it has some tangible reasons, and obviously it's just an excuse to come back onto the game and play some more, which is exactly what we're going to do. So we have the Zoltan Cruiser here, the Adjudicator, and we have three achievements. Complete two for layout B. It says shields holding, destroy the ship before it gets through the Zoltan shield. Given her all she's got, Captain, will the Zoltan Cruiser have 29 power in systems at the same time, and manpower get to sector 5 without upgrading your reactor on the Zoltan Cruiser. We're going to try and get shields holding because that is a reasonable one to go for. We are going to, well, what else have we got? We've got a beam, we've got a rocket, and we've got three characters which all provide some health to, sorry, no, they have reduced health, but they provide power to the systems, so that's pretty good. And the Zoltan shield, which is an unexplained technology, creates this nearly impenetrable shield. Only the energy outburst from an FTL engine is powerful enough to recharge it. So yeah, that's, it's all about just, you know, fighting as best you can. Let's go to easy mode because, quite frankly, it's all about getting these. And I like the way that when you check these, it does show you how you've got unlocked. Unlocked on easy, unlocked on normal, that sort of thing. Again, it's a bit like, well, it's very much like the subsequent game, Into the Breach, which I actually think is a better game. I much prefer it. I think one of the reasons why is that it tells you everything you need to know, whereas this, there is some RNG elements and percentages, and I know a lot of people don't like the combat because you've got the sort of these, well, you can miss, and they don't like that percentage one. And also, the stop-start combat can be quite annoying for some people. They don't like the fact that, you know, you're endlessly pausing and unpausing and that sort of thing. Anyway, let's go to jump and continue on. So we need to get the exit there. Let's go into probably that location and head down. I've turned on the Hellbard beam, and straight away we're into some danger zone. But we do have the target there. This is one of the auto repairers, and it does have lasers, and you can see that we are, where's our shield? Our shield points is up there, but this is our extra rating here for the Zoltan shield, which is no way we're going to be able to get to the end before this one is destroyed, because we only recharge once. Where we go, just going across here, and where do I want to fire across? Probably right across there. Can I get a better one? I don't think I'll be able to get all three. Yes, I can. So let's do that. And there's our beam, which does a lot of damage. You can see we've caused a great deal of damage there. We've caused one, two, three things to be taken out, which is fine. Our shields have been cracked, but it's not like a huge problem. We can see that shield going up there, but what I'm doing is waiting for the rock to hit it. So just waiting for that. Come on, just need one little bit, and then we'll just beam right across and zap. There we go. It is now dead. And job done. So we'll get some resources, we will get people running to repair all of this, because as you can see we have got some damage there, and mainly in the O2 bit. That's not entirely great for us. And oh yeah, we should probably, I should probably move that guy back to the shields, because, well, yes, if we don't have the shields on, we're probably going to get hit by the rock, and yeah, then that sort of thing happens. Let's just tell everybody to return the crew members back to their original positions. The reason why it stopped powering those shields is because, oh, good grief, because these shields are powered by the people themselves, because they do supply some power. I'm going to make sure we can repair that all up there. We've got the O2 back up and running. We've got probably that to open up and that to open up. We'll get some oxygen back in there and we'll move them to the front. You see they are getting damaged there, but they're almost finished. We'll actually get them into the bit there, get them healed up, and good grief, this is actually turning out really, really terrible. I'm just going to get out of the way, quite frankly, because if we stay here much longer, it's going to be all kinds of bad. This is a distress signal, and look, an enemy human mining colony where an unknown disease is spread. Ooh, they're setting up a quarantine zone. Ignore their request and move on. Sorry to say, there's no way I'm risking that. Anyway, let's see if we can sort that out, and we'll sort this one out. At least in this area, we can repair these quite reasonably well. So that is now sorted. We'll get them healed up. And for whatever reason, the fire isn't being put out. The problem with this ship is, as you can see, it is fairly difficult to maneuver around because of there's just one corridor. This corridor here is the only way from the front to the back, so it can be quite problematic, which is why I like the different layouts. So you can get a ship that you like, but you may not necessarily like the exact layout where the different ones have the different layouts. Anyway, we have been able to heal everybody, which is fine. Still on for trying to just get as much power as we can. Realistically, it's going to be either a stupidly long video or we'll never get it, but there you go. It is, after all, an excuse just to jump on this one. And it's something that I haven't really played much on this ship here. Anyway, so we have probably enough to jump. Yes, we're going to turn off the healing beam, put on the type beam. Damage per room hit, 2. Let's have a quick look. Actually, we don't need to do that. Distress call, we've said no. We're going to go over to here. We could probably laze around a bit, but I think we'll just head over here. And so we have found, after completing your jump, you receive a message from a nearby ship. Greetings and welcome to our beacon. For a small fee, we'll let you continue on your way. I reject their offer because, well, I have no reason to accept it. And what I'm worried on is that this beam might not, it might, will it damage it? I don't know if it'll damage it or not, because it's they've got their shield up. I'll give it a go. I can only try it. So they've actually got a mind control thing as well. And yes, it does. It does actually cut through their shield there. Or rather, I did hit the shield. So that's pretty good. That's actually a mind control thing. Yes, mind control. Contemporary gain control of your crew. But I think the shields have to be down. I could be making that up though, but I'm not taking any chances. I am just going to keep cutting there. They have, all right, you win. Here's some equipment from our stores. Leave us alone. I will accept their offer. And there we go. We didn't destroy them, but the shield, sadly, nowhere near where we needed to be. But I do want to upgrade to 2 shield barriers. Right, upgrade to 2 shield barriers, and we'll probably get... Let's move people back. Let's move people from the engine to there. That'll provide 1 health. And why did that turn off? There's still someone there. Oh, because we have to turn the engines on, of course. That makes sense. Well, we've got engines. And we've got 2 shields. But we don't have enough, sadly, at this stage to realistically power them all. So we need some more health. Let's go... Oh, we need some more reactor power, should I say. So jumping in, we have another... Greetings and welcome to our beacon. I'm getting the troll controls the bridge type of thing here. Looks like they have a drone, but it's a defensive drone, so I'm not too bothered about that. I should be able to get a total of 4 things here with this beam. So let you see if I can do good damage. Relationship is hostile. The achievement does specifically state destroy them before the shields have cracked. Now, because of that original hit there, it has actually done 4 damage, so this shot should kill them, hopefully. I'm going to not accept their surrender, and they're destroyed. They didn't crack the shield. There it is! Excellent. We got the achievement. I didn't think we'd get it at this stage. Shields holding, destroy a ship before it gets through. But remember, this is not just about ticking a box, an arbitrary box about just getting a little achievement or whatever. This gives us tangible benefits. It gives us a different layout, which is good because I don't really like this layout. Anyway, let's continue on. What is the next one that we could possibly do? Zolan Cruiser have 29 power in a system at the same time and don't upgrade. Now we're going to go with the other one, which is, yeah, see if we can get the power. We do have the option to get another power, which we'll accept. We'll bring that person over to there, which will not, sadly, it's not enough power to get the shields leveled up. So we will go back like so, and we can't put another point into shields, but we can put it into that. I mean, there's no reason to. No, we'll actually turn it off just in case something gets damaged. Anyway, jump to this next location. We can see that the beacon is quite close, but we don't need to be there. And so it's slavers. Recognize the ship as a well-known slave trader. He hails you and offers you laborers for cheap. 31 for Davison. We are going to attack the slaver scum because we don't like slavers. And once again, we should be able to hopefully damage four modules if we go across like that. Yes, that's excellent. So let's get this firing. Obviously, this is on easy mode. I understand that. I know that some people may think that's cheating. And we surrender. Take one of our slaves as tribute. If you destroy us, they'll die anyway. I will accept their offer, and we have a rock crewman. So the rock crewman, I will place in the... I'm going to place them in the engine room and place... Actually, no. Where do we want to place them? Well, they don't provide power. Realistically, they are very, very slow. So yes, I think putting them in the shields is not an unreasonable thing to do. Other options would be to put them in here. Let's see about that. We'll go over to ship systems. Having it crewed. See enemy interior. Or we could improve the blast doors. We don't need to improve the blast doors, really. Seeing in the enemy interior, we don't really need. And if we're honest with each other, we're just going for beam across as much damage as possible. Save the locations of that. Jump to the next destination. I'm just checking. You see the wave there. We're going to go down a bit. We're spending as much time as we can just sort of going around and fighting and doing all that. And you detect an automated rebel scout attacking a small refueling outpost. Intervene and defend the outpost because, well, we're just that kind of people. And, yes, looks like you can get three of those in total. I am going to try and get their, well, I will get their helm, their weapons, and their drone. And you can see the drone's gone. That's now gone. That shouldn't be too much of a problem now. There we go. Hopefully that will give us enough scrap to upgrade my power, which then in turn will give me enough to turn on them shields to rank 2. Not that we really need them. Oh, I had to actually turn that off by accident. Let me beam across there. Put an auto fire as well. And still taking the damage. That's good. I wonder if it causes fires. Can't check. I can't open the info screen at this stage because of where we are. But that's going to be destroyed in a matter of seconds. They have repaired, but too late. And there they go. Ship breaks apart, and you quickly salvage what you can. One fuel, one drone, which we haven't got any, and 13 scrap. And the outpost hails you after the scout destroyed. Thanks for the help. We've been harassed non-stop by those scouts. Take this on the house. So one fuel, one drone, and 26 energy. Excellent. So let's go over to here. I'm going to check out the weapons on this thing. Slow but reliable, powerful standard beam weapon. For every shield bar on the enemy, the beam's damage is reduced by one. For example, if a 3 damage beam against 2 shields cause 1 damage in every room it hits, and it has 2 damage. So yes, the 1 rating of shield will stop that. We haven't even fired the Leto missiles. The launch is outdated and weak, but can be effective. Yeah. Anyway, we have enough to get extra power, which means turning on the shields to rank 2. So that's Zoltan shields, which is very, very effective. I think we could probably go 1, 2, 3, 4, but just in case, we'll go around. Just in case something happens, you understand. And we come across another automated scout. We're going to... Oh, does not engage. Seems to be trolling around a long-range sensor station. Yeah, we'll attack because why not? Oh, that's bad. They've got 2 cannons. Actually, that isn't too bad because if we're honest with each other, we've got... Yeah, they've done 2 damage each, but it's just knocked off the Zoltan energy bar. Completely block incoming damage of any type of weapon. And I've managed to fire and take out one of theirs. It's still there, so we're still going to be taking damage. And you can see they haven't yet cracked that shield fully. Well, they've taken out the Zoltan, but they haven't done the other one. So That's pretty good. This should put their weapons out of commission. Yep, their weapons are now totally out of commission. Excellent. What are we on, actually? 15% dodge. That is fairly poor, but we do have someone at the helm, because you have to, and then someone is also back there. I wonder what their experience is. Experience is not very good, actually. There we go. And there's that being cracked, and we'll get that scrap, continue, and did we get the other stuff? Ah. Unvisited possible ship detected. Beacon coordinates appear to be very close nearby sun. We know there's a star there and the exit there. 1, 2, 3. I might be able to get round. Let's do it that way. I don't want to go into the sun. Scans reveal a mining base on a nearby planet. Long since abandoned. No signs of life. Fine, no problem. Jump to there. And looks like we're just going to make it in time. And we will continue. We will go for fix all. Get that fully upgraded. We have backup battery, mind control, and hacking. Well, we don't want to sell anything there. We also have drone recovery arm and advanced FTL navigation and all this sort of stuff. We can't afford. We've only got 39. We could probably get a backup battery. Provides a 30-second power boost for your reactor upgrade, increases the boost amount. I don't think any of that's really useful for us. We've got swarm missiles and fire bombs and all that. We pretty much have everything we need. So we're just going to repair and then we'll continue jumping to the exit. And that should be us. I wonder if there's anything guarding it. No. And you arrive at the sector greeted by a science vessel waiting on the beacon. We find ourselves low on fuel. We have a proposition. They're going to give us 2 drones. And we're going to -4 fuel. I reject the offer. It's not that I don't want to help them out. But quite frankly, I don't... Well, yeah. I just don't want to lose that fuel. So we can go to rock-controlled area or the Zoltan-controlled area. I'm going to go to rock-controlled because the weapons that we have are going to be very ineffective against Zoltan shields. So we've got a star there. We haven't got the money for it. There's no point in going back there. So we're going to head that way and then... Ooh. Let's check this. We can go that way. And that way, and that way, and around. It's going to be tight, but we can do it. So let's go unvisited location in the middle, because then we can jump elsewhere if need be. And your ship is flooded by advertisements, transmissions from nearby merchants as soon as you arrive at the beacon. Pick one to examine in detail. -1 fuel for 5 missiles. Ignore. We have no need for missiles at this stage. We are not firing them. We're just using the beam and using our shields to do that. Oh, right. Arrive in the asteroid field, immediately begin to evasive maneuvers when a loud clunk reverberates through the ship. At first you think the hull has been hit, but the noise came from some rock intruders teleporting on board the ship. They must have super shield bypass unit. Borders are on board. Intruders on board, and we will pause it. And we can see rock are over on this corner here. They will have to break through these doors, but and I have a rock person myself. The problem being that we need to probably take out... We'll do that. So we'll do a bit of damage there. And we want to get the rock guy and probably the evasive guy moving as well, because we need to start to take these guys out. So we're going to charge in. Obviously the rocks are very, very powerful indeed. Certainly when it comes to versing the Zoltan, they are a lot more powerful because we have less health. And oh, good grief, we're actually taking a fairly bad amount of damage there. I'm going to try and put out this fire. Our rock guy is fighting and okay. Apparently, the ship explodes in behind a substantial collection of useful scrap material. I somehow managed to defeat them in pretty much 1 or 2 shots. That was very unsurprising. And they're obviously damaging this ship, and there's not much I can do about that because they're currently smashing through all of that. And our shields are recharging. We don't yet have the power to put that up. What I'm going to do is turn off the weapons, increase the shields, and we are going to head over to here. We can see this has been attacked, so I'll move over the Zoltan to fight these guys. These guys can't heal, so we have the advantage there. I'm going to wait until we've got fairly low health, and then I'll run them off and then switch over with the rock guy. And oh, I'm going to lose a Zoltan. I'm going to lose one here. And yeah, I just didn't get it in time. Oh, that's annoying. I didn't get it moved in time. I forgot there's like a slight little delay and they can still attack when they're moving. They can still get attacked when they're moving through the door. That's a shame. But we did get that far. So we'll put everybody back, get them healed up, and then we will head off. There's nothing going to crack the shields now. It's just these little asteroids. That's not too much of a problem. I don't know who we lost. So we've lost looks to be our pilot, I think. Obviously, our rock guy. Magni's lost. He's got some good experience on melee. Let's put everybody back to their original locations. No, it was actually the engine person that we've lost. I'll guess remove them up to here. And these doors have been damaged. We can alter them now. And I like the way they repair them literally by punching it. The problem is that we have now lost power because that Zoltan was powering the place they were. Not too much of a problem. Let's jump here. And hopefully it's not something we have to fight. It's another asteroid field. And another pirate ship. The pirate ship, luckily... Luckily, the pirate ship doesn't have any borders. Turning on the beam weapon once again. Gonna get across there. They've got a beam as well as the cannon. Shouldn't be too much of a problem for us because it's going to carve a nice little hole. Oh, that's good. So we have destroyed... we've destroyed the O2, the drive, the shields as well as the guns, and then on top of that, the rocks came in and smashed in the back. So there we go. There's the hit that killed them. You see, I am putting that fire out there. The rock doesn't take any damage when it comes to fire. Magni doesn't take any damage there when it comes to fire, I don't believe. I'll have to check later on because I can't check there. Not going to go up the star. We are going to go that way and around. It'll be very close, but we should be able to get there. Find a disabled rock transport float near the beacon. You consider stripping it of useful parts, but are uncertain why it's been in the first place. Strip the ship or leave it alone. Strip the ship. And no one bothers in the operation. Excellent. So we have the ability to get some more power, which we will do, because then we can now turn on that shield rank 2. It would be nice to level up a little bit further. What could we level up in? We could get 3 shield barriers. That might be overdoing it a little bit. I think perhaps... more power, more better is the general rule of thumb. And now we can turn on that gun as well. And we can turn all that on if need be. I actually will not have the healing bay on, because if something starts getting damaged, we can sort it out that way. And hopefully we'll have enough points to get to where we need to go. 12 fuel, so we should be fine. You see a small trading post asking refueling, but they respond, "Go away, we don't serve your kind here." Okay, so they don't serve droids, so that's a bit of a shame. And the captain of the ship claims you can provide services as long as you've got the scrap. Hire the mercenary to delay the rebels, hire the mercenary to scout the sector, fight the ship, or you have no need of their services. So I don't really have any need of their services, and I don't particularly want to fight them, so we will move on. Obviously, with this being on easier mode, we can probably do that. This is another mercenary here as well. I'm instead going to fight this one just because I can. It looks like to be armed with... oh, well, I know that's some sort of... well, that's some sort of gun. I know that's a bit of a redundant statement, but I have no idea what that thing is. Maybe... it's going to be a... It's a hacking device, I think. No, it seems to be a scrap launcher or something. Very strange. Yeah, I think it's a scrap launcher of some kind. Either way, it's now been disabled. I can see... do you want to fire this missile? I'm going to fire the missile. There we go. See what it's like. It's a missile. Clearly, you're clearly best at us. We merely request our lives. I will accept their offer. I'm not here... I wasn't here to destroy them necessarily, just to fight a little bit, but I really do need some fuel now. 9 fuel is going to be a bit of a problem, and I think I'm going to go over there and around. Yes, on one hand, I said we were okay for fuel, and then I then said the next jump we haven't got enough fuel, and now I'm going around. I think because we'll be able to get to a star in the next location. And recognize the ship as well-known slave trader, hails you and offers you laborers for cheap. We can get flip if we buy them. I will attack the slaver scum. Sometimes if you attack them, you tend to get... They offer you what they have. I will attack the slaver scum. We might be able to get a free well, we'll liberate someone, shall we say. That is the better term, isn't it? Right, let's go for another attack, and we might be able to get, four sections there, which is excellent. They have, looks to be a standard plasma cannon of some kind, and then this charged pulse cannon, I think it is. But we should be able to beam right across, and as you can see, we've damaged their O2, we've destroyed their helm, and damaged the weapons. So, another shot, and they'll... If they're going to surrender, they'll surrender then. There you go. We will accept their offer. And we have Marfen, which is actually another Zoltan. Excellent! So, we've replaced, sadly, the lost crewman. Should I say, we replaced the crewman that we sadly lost. Not sadly, because we've got this person. Anyway, you know what I mean. Let's jump and go to the exit. We are currently just ahead of the bad guys. I was going to say rebels, but I think that's us. We see a small station where we can repair. I'm going to ignore the station. We just need to go to the next sector. NG controlled or NG homeworld. Let's go to the NG homeworlds because that is pretty cool. But we have managed to get two jumps. If we look at the map, we do have a distress signal there, but no store that I can see. We have 5 fuel remaining, so I'm hoping we can get some more there. Good power. It does. We've got 10 power bars, but we are trying to get the max power, which, what is the max power? Have 29 power in systems at the same time. So, 10, 25. Is that right? 5, 10, 15, 25. So, 25 power plus 4 Zoltan. And maybe the backup battery maybe counts that as well. Either way, we got the first one. We got the first one, shields holding, and I think we're well on the way to getting the second one. Manpower, we've already stopped. Get to Sector 5 without upgrading your reactor to the Zoltan Cruiser. We've already just put that by the wayside. You can see it says Zoltan Cruiser Quest. Complete the unlock quest for the Zoltan Cruiser unlocked on easy, and then Zoltan Cruiser Victory. Defeat the flagship with any layout of the Zoltan Cruiser. We have not yet got that done, but the task is well underway. Very much enjoying jumping back on FTL. It doesn't necessarily surprise me when I come back to it and go, this is a good game, because I think it's universally accepted, I guess, that, well, generally is. And I do enjoy it, but I don't know, just every time I come back, it seems to remind me how much I want to play it some more. And then play it and see some of the new stuff. Like, a lot of it is, you know, the moment-to-moment. Like I say, some people don't particularly like things like the RNG and misses and that sort of thing. And certainly the combat of pause and unpause and that sort of thing. But yeah, I like it. I'm enjoying it. Glad to be back. Glad to see the achievements. They are just little icing on the cake, really. More of a carrot, really, rather than the stick. So yes, come back, get these unlocked. And, you know, it just reminded me on how much I haven't got unlocked and want to see. Either way, hope you have enjoyed this little bit of FTL. If you want to see more, then by all means, let me know in the comments. Thanks so much for watching. Take care, and generic partings.